So let's look at one example of why we may need synchronization. So let's say we have two threads, and what they're doing is counting occurrences of different letters in a letter. The first thread, let's call it thread A, is counting in the first half of the document, so it's going to count occurrences of each letter in the first half of the document. And the second thread, let's call that thread B, is counting in the second half of the document, and then they will put these counts together somehow. So the code might look like this. A thread will load a letter, load from memory the count for that letter, add one to that count, and then store the new count back into memory. While thread A is doing this, thread B might be doing this. It loads a letter from its own part of the array. Note that R1 and R2 are different in these threads. This is kind of the pointer to where I got in this part of the array. This is the pointer where this thread got in its part of the array. So this thread is doing exactly the same work as this one. And as long as the letters they're processing are different, this is going to work. This thread is incrementing one part of the count array. This one is incrementing something else in the count array. But what if this thread sees letter A, and this thread at the same time sees another letter A in its own part of the array? Then what happens is they both try to load the same element from the count array. Let's say the count was 15. So this one will load 15, and this one will load 15. Now we add one, and we get 16, and we do the same here. Finally, we store 16 to memory, and here we also store 16 to memory. So now there were two occurrences of letter A, but the value in the array ends up being 16, which is only one more than the original 15. So after both of these threads are done updating the counter should have been 17, so clearly this is incorrect behavior. What we need is really that this happens and then this happens, or the other way around, but these should not be happening simultaneously because then we can get the incorrect result. If, for example, this happens first, we load, we get 15, increment store 16. Now when we load this here, cache coherence ensures that we load 16 and we end up with 17 here, which is a correct result. Similarly, if we did this first, it would produce 16 in memory, then we would load that and increment to 17. So no matter which one of these happens first, we should get the correct result, but we don't get the correct result if they happen in an interleaved fashion. They should happen one at a time, either this and this, or all of this and then all of this. So these things that have to execute kind of one at a time are called atomic or critical sections. So we have one critical section here and another one here. They can actually be the same code, it's just that both threads are currently in the same piece of code. But as you can see, if we have a section that should behave as a critical section, meaning we do this without interference from any other thread, if we just let it happen, it's not going to be done correctly. So what we need is synchronization. We need additional code that ensures that only one thread gets to do this at any given time.